friends, today let's solve subarray sum equals k. Given an array of integers and an integer k, you need to find the total numbers of continuous subarrays whose sum equals to k. Let's see this example. If we are given a numbers array that is 111, and we need to calculate the total number of continuous subarrays whose sum equals to 2. We can find this is a valid subarray, and this is also a valid subarray, so we return 2. So how to solve this problem? How do we get the subarray sum that do not start from index 0? I mean, how do we get the subarray sum start from index 1 and to index 2? Let's see. Actually, when it comes to subarray, it is a typical type of problems that is use prefix sum. Let's see. When we try to get the sum from index 1 to index 2, we can use the sum from index 0 to index 2 minus the sum starting from index 0 to index 0, which are inclusive. Because it's easy to accumulate the sum starting from index 0. If we want to get the subarray sum not starting from 0, we can use this method to get their subarray sum. Actually, this is called the prefix sum. And this idea actually is similar to dynamic programming, because when we try to get the prefix sum from index 0 to index 2, we can use the prefix sum starting from index 0 to index 1 plus the numbers 2. We save the accumulated sum and we add a new number. So basically it's dynamic programming. And usually if the given array named numbers have the length of n, the prefix sum usually have the length of n minus plus 1, because it is easier to get ending subarray sum by use two prefix sum subtraction. You see, the prefix sum 0 is just a 0, and the prefix sum 1 is equal to numbers 0, and the prefix sum 2 equals to the numbers 1 plus prefix sum 1, so on and so forth. And if we want to get the sum from index 0 to 1, we can just use prefix sum 2 minus prefix sum 0 to get this subarray sum. So even if we want to get the subarray starting from index 0, we can use the subtraction. So actually it's general. Let's return to this problem. If we want to find the total numbers of continuous subarrays whose sum equals to k, we need to count the frequency. Like we need to know how many sum of, the subarray sum appears. Let us think about, we can use the hash table, because we usually use hash table to count the frequency. For a specific key, we count their frequency. So for this problem, we can actually combine the hash table with the prefix sum. We can just save the pre-sum as the key of the hash table. So this hash table means how many times this pre-sum appears. That means we only need to iterate the numbers array once, and we keep record the sum starting from 0. And when we try to see whether we can get a subarray sum equal to k, that means we only need to check whether previously exists a subarray starting from 0 has the prefix sum of sum minus k. So that means that there must be some subarray has the sum of k. obviously time complexity is big O n because we only iterate these numbers once. And for the space complexity, worst case, we need to save all the prefix sum in the hash table, so it should be big O n. Okay, now let's write the code. We first get n, which is the number's dot length, and we will use hash table. Both the key and the value is integer, which is a code map. As in, when we save prefix sum in an array, we use n plus 1, and the prefix sum 0 is 0. And when we use hash table, we must save 0, 1. We need to put 0, 1 in it, because that means the prefix sum starting from 0 appears once. That will be easier for us to check whether we can get a subarray starting from index 0. Okay. And we need a sum starting from 0. We also need a result to calculate how many numbers of these subarrays. And then we iterate these numbers. The sum plus current number. And we will check if map contains key numbers minus k. That means we find a valid subarray. So result should minus this map get sum minus k. And we need to put this prefix sum to the map. So map get or default. If it doesn't appear before, so it's 0, then plus 1. Finally, we return this result. If we do not put 0, 1 to the map, we accumulate the sum. Here the sum equal to 2. Actually, we already find a valid subarray. But we do not save this 0. So we will not find a valid subarray. Okay, so we need to put this 0 to the map. Okay, thank you for watching. See you next time.